a couple of local lawmakers.
Filmmakers.
Filmmakers. I
mean, it's easy to get them
mixed up. It's easy to get them mixed up, but in this
case,
they
both make stuff.
It is. Filmmakers are touring the country, showcasing their latest documentary.
That's right. Their project, In Their Shoes, follows several men whose lives intersect in prison and have one common denominator. Astrid in the ATL speaks with the director. Astrid.
Yeah, we have some pretty heavy hitters making this documentary. It was produced by Emmy-winning and former General Hospital actress Natalia Livingston and her student. They're both Atlanta residents, and they actually teamed up with one of the famous Wahlberg brothers, you know. Donnie Wahlberg, all the Wahlbergs. Well, they're bringing you this documentary to shine a light on the opioid epidemic and how it affects people from different backgrounds in different ways.
I was 14 years old when I tried coke for the first time. That's also the age that I was actually locked up for the first time, too.
They come from all different walks of life, different income brackets, and different races. But all these men have one thing in common.
They were all incarcerated for drug-related crimes due to their addiction. Mm-hmm. So they fell into it to a level where you get sick if you don't get your drugs and you're willing to do anything mm-hmm. at that point. And so they committed robberies or various crimes.
He quickly held up the gun right at the person as I was walking in, told him to step away back from the counter.
Taylor Katsanis, an Atlanta resident, is the director of In Their Shoes. The hard-hitting documentary follows four men working to overcome labels such as criminal and drug dealers.
Everybody has a story to tell.
In Their Shoes comes at a critical time when drug overdoses fueled by opioids are now the leading cause of death for Americans under the age of 50.
It's been a crisis for a long time and it's just sort of bursting into the public consciousness.
The film is an intimate portrayal of these men's lives and how race affected their prison sentences.
The judge, he wouldn't accept the plea agreement for me of anything less than a second degree life sentence.
One of our individuals who's much older and served the 27 years was from the crack cocaine epidemic mm-hmm. in the 80s.
It also focuses on their journey in a prison reentry and addiction recovery program.
I think a lot of people on the outside can think that these guys need to get their life together and it's just that simple. Mm-hmm. And for a lot of them, it's much more complicated.
Yeah, we blow them out, man. You make a wish.
And what's unique about this film is that we actually get to learn these men's stories in their own words, what they, you know, led them to commit the crimes, and we witness their complexities of their stories depending on their race.